But we, anyhow, we want pure happiness. And what is pure happiness? There is happiness, but not in this world. And that is called Brahmananda. What a jiva can taste in himself. If he can attain salvation, then he can test Brahmananda, no distress at all. But Brahmananda is also not pure, not any affirmative, negative way. Like, what is negative? What negative? If a man has caught anyone and he was going to
choke his.
Then he was crying, save me, save me, save me. And he was about to die. And he was pushing. But anyone came and saved him. And then he stood up and now I'm saved. So this is salvation and this is Brahmananda life. Not positive anything. But if you are serving Krishna, really that is happiness. Otherwise not. Krishna is embodiment of Ananda. I am Anandam, I am Brahma. If you are not following, serving, chanting, remembering Krishna, you cannot be happy in any way. So this is called not Brahmananda, this is called prema, love and affection to Krishna. And these are so many various of kinds. So he wants happiness, but he does not know what is happiness. Really, this to serve Krishna and the love and affection of gopis, serving Krishna and they are having so much ananda, ananda pure. So, really we want like such love and affection, but we don't know what is that. But we want to happiness like such. Oh, if anyone wants to be happy, Krishna has transformed into Shastra. So, in Shastra is written that if you will follow my instructions, you can have that kind of love and affection. So, Shastra has told. And in all Shastra, Srimad Bhagavatam is Amal Shastra, to whom you can rely and believe. He cannot cheat you, because Srimad Bhagavat is the embodiment of Krishna himself. For in all Shastra it has been written that if you will serve Krishna, then you will really be happy. If you are chanting, remembering Krishna, then by doing bhakti to Krishna, Bhagavan Krishna, Swayam Bhagavan Krishna, will be happy and then you must be happy. But Srimad Bhagavat was telling, he is telling some difference. What? Srimad Bhagavat is telling, O all jivas, you have no power, no, you have no qualification that you can serve Krishna. Never you can. You are like powerless. You cannot serve. You cannot call Krishna. Never you can call. All Shastra has told that you should remember and call Krishna. Hare Nam, Hare Nam, Hare Nam. Kalau Naste, Naste, Naste. It has told in Vishnu Purana or other Purana, not in Srimad Bhagavata. So all Shastra have told that you should do bhajan to Krishna. But Srimad Bhagavata, what is telling? Oh, you cannot call Krishna. Oh, Krishna is descending to call you. He is so merciful. Out of mercy, he has descended to this world. You cannot go there. Answer. Can you go to Vrindavan, Gokul, Navadvip, Dham there, Shwetadvip? You cannot go. You cannot call him. But Krishna is so, Krishna of Srimad Bhagavatam is so merciful. He took his float and he descended to this earth in Vrindavan and he was calling to all. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, you should only hear from, you should give your ears. Only ear. Not I don't want anything. Guru, the real guru, qualified guru, only tells. Oh, give your ears to me. I don't want anything. Your wealth, your anything I don't want. I want your and I want to purify your ears. And by ear, I will give something in your heart that you will be happy forever. Transcendental happiness will come to you. Other, there is no other process to be happy. You are crying for Krishna, but your crying has no power. How your crying? I am giving an example. Our crying is like this. Oh, there was a very beautiful class, very powerful class. All the devotees were there. And those who were speaking Srimad Bhagavatam, telling Harikatha, he has so much fear. And also long hair. And it was quietly, it has become white. And he was telling like this and that. And his beard was. All were attentively hearing. And old ladies, oh, he was sitting there. And always weeping. Tears coming. The Sadhu Baba who was speaking Harikatha, when it was finished the class, all went gracefully. And lady was there. He called that lady, oh mother, well, you are very high class of deed. By what Harikatha touched your heart? And why you are weeping so bitterly? Then he again began to weep more and telling that, Baba, what to tell? I have a... What? Not Bakari, Bakari. Male goat. And he was so strong. And he has so much beard like you. Just sometimes I used to give something to eat and then he happily used to eat like this. So when you are telling Baba Harikatha, your yes, like my, I remember always my that goat, and anyone has just stolen away what to do. I am weeping for that. So our calling to Krishna is like that. So, it may be some semblance, but not semblance, pratibimba.
Reflection.
Our arti should be pure. Oh, we cannot have that kind of arti. Arti means?
Sincere prayer.
With separation mode. From heart, core of heart. But Krishna has this. And that is why he descended. Oh, lakhs and lakhs, koti. More than us. He is weeping for us. because he is father of father of father, beloved of beloved of beloved. He has so much love and affection for us. Oh, they are suffering so much for getting me. They cannot come to me. They cannot even call me, weeping bitterly, not heart melted. So I must go to them. And that is why he descended. With his flow, his all beauty, essence of the, all the beauty he took, and he came. And he is calling us, but we are not hearing. Try to realize this. Sarva bhuta manoharam ajab jagam kalau bam disha manoharam. Oh, he took his flute and he was singing on cling and he was calling. But we cannot hear this sound also. We are not so much qualified. So, we cannot go to Krishna and call. That is why Krishna came. Even in the form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, conjugal, both they came. Only to call us. And he went here and there, and he took sannyas, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu life. So, Bhagavata is telling like this. Nidama kalpataru rukalitanga phalam sukham khad amrit tavasam pivata bhagavatam rasamalayam bhurho nasikaram. Krishna became like fruit, nigam kalpataru fruit. No? Nothing, nothing. Only a rasa, rasa, rasa. And he was brought by whom? Sukadeva Goswami in Guru Parampara. So, Krishna has descended to this world to call us. Why? Oh, don't be suffering. Be happy. Transcendental happiness you should have and to give. But we are not qualified. Even to this, we don't want to be transcendental happy. Oh, Bhagavata is telling, Kangva dayalum sharanam brajam. He is asking to all others, Ved, Upanishad, Puran, Mahabharata, Ramayana, to all, Srimad Bhagavati question. Kangva dayalum sharanam brajema. He is asking, but none is replying. And then Srimad Bhagavat himself, oh bakiyam stanakalvitam. Even a demon like putana, always taking the flesh and new bloods of babies everywhere. So this demon, and went to kill Krishna. And what Krishna did? He changed his cloth, he changed his body, and he sent to Vaikuntha, more than that. So we should try to serve Krishna and to hear Krishna. We should be qualified. How you can? Or through any qualified devotee. Like guru, devotee, same thing. You cannot go. So all Shastra has told that all human want happiness and they want to meet with Krishna. But Bhagavad tells what? Bhagavan wants jeev. You know also that in all Shastra, it has been told that when Krishna went to Mathura and Gopi was feeling separation, then all Shastra are telling what? That Gopis sent any Hansa, swan, where? To Mathura, to tell their separation news, how they are suffering. But Srimad Bhagavata is telling another thing, what? Krishna was suffering so much. And he was suffering so much that he had to send his messenger. Understanding? Gopis are not sending, but Krishna is sending. because she is so merciful. So merciful. So bhakti is so much katar for Bhagavan. Katar means? Always suffering, always weeping, separation, feeling separation. Hankering. But Srimad Bhagavat was telling opposite. Krishna is hankering from his devotees. Always. Krishna always calling what? Oh mother, mother. And he is searching where my boyfriend are here. All Gwalbal. Brahma has taken them. And he is searching them. So Krishna is searching us. But we are so unqualified that we cannot hear his flow. We cannot call with her. So we should try. But you can only try when your heart is so empty and you have taken the shelter of any high class of devotees. Then Krishna has come and has gone to Mathura. Now in the beginning I told 5 or 6 questions. No? What questions? Braja, Vrindavan, Gokul, Mathura, Gokul and all other. Braja, Bhumi, is a place of so high class of love and affection. No? Vrindavan is himself, itself, rasa. So why Krishna left Vrindavan and went to Mathura and to Dwarka? Why?
Duty, Maharaj!
Why? Oh.
He saw it as a duty, Maharaj.
So there is a question. But why Krishna? He is ocean of Raps himself, and Vrindavan is also ocean of Raps. And even he left it. Secondly, if he went, if there was any cause, we go anywhere for any special reason, cause, and if cause is finished, we return. So if Krishna has left Vrindavan for any special reason, a special cause, that cause should be finished and he should return to Vrindavan. But he never returned. Oh. What is the answer of this? Anyone wants to live at a place where he receives so much love and affection. He doesn't want to taste any lower kind of
love and affection.
Like if you are having rasagolla, then if anyone giving you some good in India or anything, you cannot take it. You want to set rasagolla first. So, why Krishna? Lover like gopis, Mother Jashoda, Nanda Baba and others. And quickly he left in a day and he never returned. Why? Third question. Oh, if he is not coming forever, but he can come time to time. What harm? If anyone has gone, come to America from India to make some money, and if money is sufficient, and then he can return. If in case he is not returning, but he can go to India to meet his relatives, he may go. So Krishna, why not going to meet their relatives, his father and mother? He should go. But he is not going at all. Or today he is sending a messenger. But why not himself going? He's sending messenger. Messenger can do the same thing what Krishna can do. You know that they will be not satisfied. They will only be satisfied if I am going there. But he is sending messenger and giving what? A letter to them that you should give this and this, this message to them. Or if there is so much heavy reason, cause, heavy means? Important cause and reason, that he cannot go, return to them. Then there is some way that he can call all the Brajavasi to Mathura or Dwarka. There is no lacking of any space, so much space. He can do anything. He can supply all houses and boarding and everything, as he gave, hosted all Mathura Vasi. So he can bring all, and he will be in Mathura, in Dwarka, he should be in Mathura, and with all Prajavasi. Why he is not bringing them? Oh, if you want to know all the answers of all the questions, then you will have to go deep in Srimad Bhagavatam. With any high class of devotees who has served his Gurudev, the devotees, and he has served Bhagavatam with Bhagavatam. What is meaning? He should serve Bhagavatam with Bhagavatam. Because the key and lock is in the hands of Mahabhagavatam. We don't want to serve any Mahabhagavatam. We don't want to give honor to all, but we want that our all answers should be satisfied. Huh? How it can be? So Krishna is so merciful. He is sending his any kinds of devotees. Oh, go and tell some answers. So that they may be advocated like this. Now you are coming to our questions, that answer. That it is to first question and answer. Why he left? Why he left? I told one reason of Prem Sarovar. Krishna is so worried that gopis when with me, they felt so much preparation mood for future, and they become like lifeless in prem vaichitya, in mahabhav, in what? Prem vaichitya arekta? Dipyonmar. You cannot imagine all these things. And feeling so much separation mood. Burning in fire of separation. So Krishna wanted that. If I am out of Vrindavan, they will feel in separation, and in separation mood they will meet me. In dream, even. In any way. They will see Tamal and they will embrace like Krishna, that, oh, direct, we are meeting with him. And then they will be happy. Or they will take something and they will decorate themselves. So I must be. Secondly, he is telling that it is true that anyone wants to be there where he is plenty of ananda, happiness. He don't want to go to any place where there is less happiness and less love and affection. But this is not the nature of Krishna. Supreme Personality of Krishna, Godhead. His nature is some different. What? He has lakhs and lakhs devotees everywhere. Also there are some devotees in Mathura, and they have been given so much sufferings by Kans, feeling so much. From when? Devaki and Vasudev are suffering from the very day when their marriage was going to happen. Krishna was there for about 10 years, 8 months in Braja. And from beginning of marriage, 8 sons were there with Krishna. So many years. And after that, 10 years, 8 months more. How much years together?
About 19 years.
19 years? Yes, it may be. It may be like 20 years, it may be. And they were being suffered by cancer. So many persons left Mathura. They scattered here and there. And those who were there were always weeping and suffering. So how Krishna can give up them? He cannot neglect. He should care. And if he is not taking care, then he is not merciful at all. Also Pandavas are weeping, Kunti is weeping for Krishna that he should come and help us. Draupadi calling him, "Oh, I am now becoming shameless. And she is calling bitterly, "Oh, kissing his hands, "Oh, Govinda, Raku Sarana, Avata Jivana Hari. Now I am dying." What Krishna will do? If he is playing in Ras Lila, in Vrindavan, in Bansi, but what he will do? He will have to save also. Any bhakta in anywhere in this world, and he is calling Krishna, Krishna cannot remember. Otherwise, he will have to give up his name that you are Bhakta Vatsal. You are merciful. So he will have to take care of all. And that is why he was testing so much rush in Vrindavan. But also he will have to look after all the devotees. So there are so many devotees in Mathura, here and there. He should also hear their call. That is why Krishna also went there no harm. But something more. Because Krishna has promised, "Je jathang mam prapadyante tam tathayo bhajamaham." Those who are serving me, I will have to repay them in the same way. But only there are gopi that he could not keep his promise. He failed to keep his promise. For all he can keep his promise, but for gopi. So, it is sure that there is no comparison of whole world's any devotees like Brajavasi. Anyone cannot compare. Like Jashoda mother, like Sudal Subhansu and all others, like Gopis, Lalita Vishakha and all others. Oh, there is no comparison. But Devaki and Vasudev, they have also did austerities, very hard austerities in that past. But, you know, keeping their head down, standing on one here, and taking their feet high, without any air, water, in hot day, in winter season, rainy season, always. How much? More than 60,000 years. Dhruva has done only, how much?
Six months
without air. And he, more than 60,000 years. And now he is calling in the form of Vasudeva and Devaki. Will he not hear? He must hear. This was also a reason to come to Mathura. Now, second thing, if Krishna finished his that cause, he came to save his father, mother, and he saved and he killed Kansa. So he came to kill Krishna, Kansa, and he finished this cause, then he must return to Vrindavan. But how he can? All the Jadvasi, Mathuravasi has escorted here and there for the fear of. So his whole kingdom was like Vishrinkal. Vishrinkal means? It was not in order. So Krishna gave the kingdom to Ugrasen Maharaj. He made him king. But he was so much old, powerless person. Krishna should manage. So he was managing. And if he is not managing, that what will be? Oh, there were two wives of Kans, Asti and Prapti. They went to their father, Jarasandha, who was very big demon like. Very powerful, more than Kansa and all others, Duryodhana and all. And when he heard that, his son-in-law has been killed by Krishna, and he was innocent. Oh, already innocent. And this Krishna killed him. He was sitting on the throne only, and they jumped and took his, and without any reason, and they killed. He became so unhappy, serious. And he took his soldiers, more than Mahabharata soldiers, army, so much army. 20 lakhs or crores of army he took, and he invaded at 18 times, not only 10, 18 times. So Krishna knows that if I am going to Braja, then what happened? All will be killed by Jarasandha. So he cannot go. Can he go? If he goes to Vrindavan time to time, that what will become? Krishna wanted to go time to time. But if Jarasandha will know that really, all the Brajvasi are so beloved, so dear to Krishna, so I will mash Vrindavan. There are no soldiers, no army, no killa, fort, nothing. And they are not warriors all go. Only grazing cow, very innocent. So in one day, Jarasandha will come and smash whole Vrindavan. But Nanda Baba knows this. So Krishna told in his ear, don't be restless. I will come after finishing Jarasandha and all, and I will come. So I must come. But if I am now coming, time to time that Kansa will, they will know, and they will attack whole Vrindavan. And then everything will be finished. I cannot save you. There is no fort, no army, nothing. So he is not coming. And more things. One thing, anyone goes to anywhere for any job or any duty, Vasudeva knows this very clearly, Vasudeva and Devaki, that Krishna has come from Vrindavan. And if Krishna returns to Vrindavan, he will never come. If anyone goes to anywhere, and Krishna tells that I am going to Indra Prastha, I am going to Mithila, or I am going here and there, they will know, never object. That you should go and very quickly you should return. But if Krishna wants any permission from Devaki and Vasudeva, that I want to go quickly to Vrindavan and I will return. Then they become very worried and they began to weep, nothing telling anything, not giving
permission.
Why not? That Vrindavan is a Rasamayi Bhumi. He is not going to finish any karma or any job or anything. And he will go and he will be totally absorbed in Rasa. Because Vrindavan is Rasamayi Bhumi. Krishna is himself Rasa. All the gop and gopis are Rasa. So, this is not a job, not a duty, not a anything. So he will not return. So when Krishna anyhow tells that, may I go? They began to wait bitterly. Not only Devaki was the whole Mathura-vasi began to wait. That we will die today. What Krishna should do? That is why. Or sometimes he wants to go but cannot go. These are the reasons. Also, if he is going there sometimes and only meeting with them and he can return, because Vrindavan is only two fingers far away from Vrindavan, Mathura, only. And the place is what? Borderline. Only Mathura and Vrindavan, so near or near. He can go to Golok Vrindavan, he can go to Mithila, he can go to Dwarka in a moment. And why he cannot come in hour, 2 hours, he can come to Vrindavan. But he is not coming. Why? Because if he is going for a moment, then what becomes? The separation mode of gopis and gops will go less and less time more. More and more. It will not subside, but it will increase so much. Why? If there is a lamp, the lamp of? What? Lamp mein kya hota hai?
Flame.
If there is a flaming lamp, if there is a little air, it can be extinguished, it can be subsided. But if the fire is so in so big,
jungle,
like
forest fire,
can it be subsided by any air, or what it will be? More increasing. So,